The following is a behind-the-scenes look at a failed attempt to advertise for the dorms. Warning, what you are about to see may be disturbing if you enjoy the following. Scripts, script-based films, hygiene, silence, normal people, etc. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hello, and welcome to a tour of the St. Croix dorms, hosted by Captain Chainsaw.
That's me!
Yeah. As some of you may know, I'm Jake, the good captain's roommate, and I'll be your tour on this documentary of sorts. But first, let's go in. There's very good security here in the dorms, as all the doors are always locked. Of course, us dorm students have a way of getting in. We use these fobs, and we put them up these little sensor things, and it should hopefully unlock the door right away. We go in, and the door instantly locks to keep out unwanteds or our friends to annoy them.
Ah!
And here is the dorm study room. It's a room set aside solely for studying, as indicated by this sign. And if you'll follow me, we have a hallway. There's sign-out sheets, a dorm office that's rarely used, a bathroom, a broom closet, a fire extinguisher, a courtyard that is as of yet unused, but we plan on putting a Mortal Kombat pit in it, a mech room, where you can find everything from Gundams to nightmares, and the kitchen and rec room, where we'll be going next. The dorm kitchen has various features that make it more convenient to dorm student life. These include a Coke vending machine, a fridge, cupboards stocked mainly with water heating implements, random people's bikes, a sink, formerly a microwave. Remember kids, trying to microwave a raw egg is no good. Random people's golf clubs, and a laundry room if you ever want clean clothes for some reason.
The dorm rec room is the main hanging out place in the dorms. Some of its features include a new TV that miraculously hasn't been broken by the door that swings dangerously close to it.
An older TV with a 5-disc DVD player hooked up to it. Why anyone would bother needing 5 discs, especially considering you don't want to leave anything in here otherwise it'll get broken, I have no idea. Foosball tables, a pool table, broken piano, the forbidden ping pong realm, a fireplace that lacks a chimney, and fire, and the library with who knows what. We like to keep things clean here in the dorms, which is why every week on Monday and Thursday, there are required dorm duties where you have to clean up various rooms around the dorms. Zabel here is currently cleaning the rec room. As you can see, it's a very, very intense job.
It's a gold mine! Money, 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 money.
Of course, there are some rewards.
Money!
Moving on. Now, what I'm sure a lot of you are wondering is what the dorm rooms themselves are like.
Yes!
They come in various shapes and sizes, and 7 eyes is a basic 2-person room. Let's go in now. Let's come back later. Now many of you have probably already seen Sam's earlier video, My Dorm Room, and are already familiar with the layout of our room. But for those who don't, I'm gonna recap. We have many things such as lightsabers, the Pope, some clothes, my awesome light cosplay, Sam's base, some drawings, which are pretty cool that I did, Zelda poster, Sam's crutches, which are funny because his dad said not to sprain his wrist on him and then he did. The Lamp of Fail, where we keep our change, Mushroom Men posters, awesome Chronicle posters, our ninja tips for a healthy living.
Ich bin eine kleine Tasse des Sonnenschein, Fulstein Nippen.
Seriously, Brayden, we're filming. Of course, us crazy high schoolers aren't just left alone. Every dorm, boys and girls, has 2 dorm supervisors who are teachers at the school. They're kind of like the parents of the dorms and always there to lend a helping hand. Provided they're on duty, of course. In addition to them, there are 2 elected resident advisors, or RAs for short, who are students of the dorms themselves. They're also there who are, and are quite friendly to help us out. Hey, here's one right now. CJ, aka c-blazzle. Hey, c-blazzle, what's up?
Hey, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Sam Flam, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Working on the video, you know?
You know what? Go to bed right now.
What are you talking about? What, Jake, what time is it?
It's 6:30.
Where'd he go?
Room now!
The natural silence of the dorms is a great place for studying. In addition to the normal quiet, there's also a required study hall every Monday through Thursday from 7 to 8:30. This is also the time when those who have required study hall can get a little extra peace and quiet. Now, of course, required study hall is only for those who are failing classes or are new students. So if you want to stay out of that and have free time to do whatever you want, just keep those grades up.
I'm a fire in my laser!
Now, what I'm sure you're probably wondering is, do they feed you here? And the answer is, of course, yes. And the food is usually delicious. Usually.
Now, for our female viewers, we'd love to show you what your dorms are like, but unfortunately, we're dudes, and therefore it is forbidden. But fortunately for you, your dorms are part of the main building, so you never even have to leave.
Unlike us.
Hey, I'm the host guy. I say when we move on.
Moving on. I hope you've enjoyed this little tour. And for those of you who live far away and aren't in high school yet, I'm hoping you'll consider coming here. It's a really great video.
Oh, I'll cut that out.
Okay, so, as I was saying, for those of you who aren't in high school yet, and maybe live a little far away, I'm hoping you'll consider coming here. It's a great place to study and hang out with friends. We all really get along and stuff. Dude, stop playing music.
I'm trying to find a good song for the credits.
Yeah, but do that later. Now we have to film this part again.
No, we don't. I'm saving time.
Yeah, but
time management.
Did you film? What song in this?
Whoa!
Mercy!
Stop filming!
No, this is awesome!
No!